Good morning and welcome my dear students. So you all are welcome again to this video subject session of SS, where today we are going to discuss that how we can create awareness among the people regarding the forest to conserve and to maintain it. Until our last discussion, we have seen many plants and animals we are not used to see nowadays because of them. The reason that we are cutting the forest without thinking anything from the viewpoint of the nature. So for the students, there is should be a balance in the environment if the relative number of species is not disturbed. Now, species is anything which we can say that the number of the animals and the birds, the different varieties of animals and birds, the flora and fauna. Flora is related to the species of the plants and fauna is related to the species of the animals. So the flora and fauna nowadays, which we can say that most of the times we cannot see this species particularly in the nature. Human activities in several parts of the world have disturbed natural habitats of many species. The many human activities, due to the human activities, the nature is said to be disturbed in many parts of the world. The forest has been cut. The forest used to be the house for many of the animals and birds. And due to the forest has cut, there should be an imbalance. The animals entered into the human settlement most of the times, and humans, because to save them, to defend them, they kill the animals. There started to be creating the imbalance between the same. Due to indiscriminate killing, several birds and animals have either become extinct or are on the verge of the extinction. And due to this reason, students, we can say that the animals most of the times cannot be seen because we are doing the killing of the animals to sell the body parts and to sell their several other parts, body organs. Awareness programs like social forestry and Van Mahotsav should be encouraged at the regional and community level. And for this, there should be the awareness programs. These awareness programs should be such like that should encourage the regional and community level. School children should be encouraged for the bird watching and visiting nature camps. The school children should be encouraged so that they should have a feeling to view the nature, so that they should create in their own mind that their duty is to save the nature. If human beings and if the future generation is not going to save the nature, then who else will save it? It is our moral responsibility. Many countries have passed laws declaring that the trades as well as the killing of birds and animals are illegal. So for this, many countries have passed the legal laws for the killing of the birds and the animals. The illegal killing should be stopped. In India, killing of lions, tigers, deers, great Indian bustards and peacocks have been banned. So in India, for this law, killing of birds and animals is considered to be illegal. We cannot kill any animal, whether it is the tiger or it is the lion. The great Indian bustard is an animal, is a bird which is famous, which is now rarely seen in the Indian forest. The great Indian bustard actually is a bird. And peacocks have been banned. Most of the times the people used to kill the peacocks of only the reason to get the body organs or to get the feathers of the peacock. So this should not be done. And international convention sites have been established that list several species of animals and birds in which trade is prohibited. What does it say? An international convention sites has been established that list several species of animals and birds in which trade should be prohibited. We should not kill the birds and we should not kill the animals, which they are used to be prohibited. Conservation of plants and animals is an ethical duty of every citizen. And for this, the conservation of plants and animals is an ethical duty. It's a moral duty of every citizen to conserve this plants and animals. And for this reason only, the plants and animals which we are looking about should not be killed. Students, this is the one which we have discussed. You can look at here. There is a great herd of the chitals. Chitals is an animal actually which now is being rarely seen in the forest. And the elephants herd in the Kaziranga National Park in Assam. So students, this is how We have learned in the chapter that the animals and the birds and which we are looking about in the nature should not be killed for the body organs and different parts. So for this students, with this session, thank you. Have a nice day to all.